The views, comments, and opinions of the following program do not necessarily reflect those of Morris Media Studios, MorrisMediaLive.com, or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
Sound like we're on the Bill Cosby Show. That's that nigga, you know he ain't paying for no music. Shit, you know what it is.
You remember that stupid ass reality show? He did that elevator music with that big black dude. He the reason why, that's why he rich. Because he did all the elevator music in the elevator.
Same.
The black dude with all them kids and he used to come on.
George Front?
Nah, it was recent. I can't think of it. He was a bald headed dude and he had a wife and her and the sisters was jealous and they had a gang of kids and... Anyway, whatever. I can't think of that name.
Oh, the white dude.
No, he black.
Oh.
And he make elevator music. Boring as fuck.
That's crazy. Yeah.
He looked like he would make it. Though.
Yeah. Crazy, but still genius, you know, at the same time. What's up, y'all?
I know we here at a special time.
Yes, we here on an odd ass Thursday.
Yeah.
But it's, you know, it's for a great reason. You know what I'm saying? We had to just, but you know what? When you a boss like Poe, you could just, hey, you know what? I know the show usually Monday, but this week, bam!
Yeah, when you have your
shit.
Own channel and shit, huh?
Excuse me.
We interrupting programs.
But see, what we had to do is that my boo, that's why she over here glowing. She is pregnant. No, I'm lying.
Man.
No, but she does have a gift, and she had to go share that gift with the world. So she wasn't able to be here Monday. She had to fly out on our ass, go to the East Coast.
Yeah, all the way to the East Coast on a plane.
What?
I didn't, you know, look.
How did you feel? Okay, how was it? Tell us all about it.
After I got over the plane ride. Because, you know, I hate planes.
Right.
Okay, so after I got over that, it was good.
It was. But was the, okay, you know how you could not like planes, but then it could just be a shitty-ass ride, and sometimes it's a smooth ride, you just don't like planes. So was it like that? Or?
It was a smooth ride. I mean, everything was fine. Nothing happened, but I was just still like...
I don't want to
die. Measure 45,000 feet in the air. Just it just kept going over and over and over and over and over and over. So
I'm cool until we start jiggling. You know what I'm saying? And like, oh, we're going to turn the seatbelt sign back. Oh, shit. Like, here we go with this bullshit.
Fuck the whole thing. I wish I could just drive. Like, okay. But it would have took too long. But I only trust myself.
Bitch, and it's a million other people on the road.
Look, if some shit start happening, I'll be all in the cockpit like, are you good, my nigga? Like, do you need me to read the manual? Do you know what the fuck to do next? Like, I'm for real. Is there some parachutes around this motherfucker? Like, I couldn't. I can't. It's too much.
Stupid. Welcome, y'all, though. Welcome, y'all. I'm sorry. We didn't do the introduction right. We get to talking all the damn time. Welcome to the G-Spot on a Thursday. The G today is for grateful because we are so grateful for all the many blessings that are raining down. Rain in the
woods. And we called it too. Like, remember two G spots ago? We was like, I feel blessings coming. We didn't even know. They were just coming. They just started coming left and right. Like, bam.
Looky, looky. Grateful. So, tell us about your trip. Kamira, we had to go to New York because of, what did you do exactly?
I went to New York to film my set for 50 Central.
Set is a comedy.
Comedy set. He's doing, he's putting together like a SNL, like a nigga SNL. Like, you know, it's going to be sketches, stand-up, all kind of different stuff. It was hella fun. I met 50. And it's crazy because it's not even that I met 50. Like, this nigga was damn near modeling because, you know, when you film, you got to switch it up, right?
Right.
This nigga was putting on bomb-ass suits. Every time I seen him, he was walking out in another suit. I was like, God damn. I couldn't even keep my composure because I get used to one look, and the nigga come out and switch up on me. I'm like,
again?
Yeah.
What scene is this?
I'm like, he was so cool, too. He was just like, oh, you come here. How you doing? Like, stuck his hand out or whatever, and I was like, I want to grope you. But I didn't. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I wanted to tell him all. I was dreaming about the nigga the whole time. Like, the night before, I was dreaming, like, you know what I'm saying? I was his quarter piece because I'm too big to be a dime, you feel me? Like, I'm bigger than a dime, so I'm a quarter, you 50.
Look, and you know this some nigga shit because anybody else would be like, you know what I'm saying? I feel my shit. I say I hit that shit. Like, she killed her fucking set, but all she is talking about is 50.
Man, I wanted to just talk about him the whole time. I wanted to just get up there like...
And y'all picture did look like y'all was a couple. I'm like, oh.
I just wanted to say, can I have your undershirt? So I just... Let me sleep in your undershirt.
Straight up. Let me just smell you. And if y'all don't know, like, some of y'all might be new to this show. Kamira been going through it, dog. Like, a lot of shit. And yeah, she laugh at shit and keep it comedy, because, nigga, that's our job. But in real life, it's a lot of stuff that people would not make it through. You know what I'm saying? Be done throw in the towel. So, yeah. This is big, y'all. This is real big. Y'all need to call in and congratulate my motherfucking partner. 323-293-3375. And this motherfucker for real. 50? You know he got power. Y'all know he is a powerful motherfucker. Shit.
I mean, he is. You could feel the power, too. Yes. You could feel it. He was real cool, though. He was hella cool. He was joking around.
It's fine. Always good when they like that. And not, you know.
He fine, serious. You know what I'm saying? It was amazing.
Oh,
it was amazing.
Big ups.
And everybody that worked there, the staff at BET, they was cool. Everybody was cool. It was cool. They fed us and shit. Wasn't all that, but the food was, I mean, you know they be having them white caterers and shit. They needed more seasoning on it, but the watermelon was good.
And the thought was there. Look. All right, we got a phone call. Look. Hey, what's up, Kyla? What's your name? Where you calling from?
Again, this is Larry Goodwin. I'm calling from Houston, Texas.
Oh, my boo. Hi, Larry.
Zeddy.
Yeah, hey, Kamira. Mm-hmm. First of all, congratulations.
Woo-woo. Thank you, boo. So much. I appreciate you.
First of all, you're in Houston. How are you doing?
Right. Sorry, yes.
Shit.
Oh, I'm cool. We didn't really catch any rain. I'm in the suburbs, so we got a little bit of rain, and that's it.
Okay. They got money.
I'm in the good section. So it didn't rain.
We're
on
not
me.
Below sea level around here. We on the Upper East Side.
On the upper.
Hey, second question. Did Precious, I told her the week before last to give you a hug and tell her it was from me. Did she do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Right. She always give me hugs and
already. Mm-hmm. Already.
Okay. Well, when you coming back, nigga?
Yeah, no, fuck. Yeah.
When you coming back?
I got about 10-15 more bricks to sell, and then I will be back.
Okay, well, if you need a bitch to jump on a Greyhound for you, let me know.
I used to move work out of town on Greyhound.
I'll strap it up, you know what I'm saying? They won't even know, put the hoodie on. They just think I'm plushed out.
You can hide them under your titties.
All of that.
All right, y'all. I'm
going to
get back to watching y'all
because
I can't hear y'all. I'm on the phone. So, love y'all.
I love you, too.
Love you, babe.
All right, bye.
Bye. Aww, shout out to Larry. We love Larry.
I know. Rape his ass.
I know. We're going to make a special trip down to H-Town suburbs. And
that nigga said, I'm in the suburbs.
Actually, I'm looking down like blue on the peasants.
Everybody is adding Beyonce. It's a lot of pressure when shit like that happens.
But you know what? What people don't understand is, like, everybody is not a, hey, world, look at me helping the people. Look at me giving my money. Like, it... In the Bible or whatever, we don't know what she believed, but a lot of times it really does say that you should give. You messing up the blessing when you start telling what you're doing. Yeah. Like, I understand if it's a challenge, like you just got money, it's a challenge, everybody throw in 25. Yeah. But I'm saying to really be on there like, I'm doing my part, here go all my canned goods, I'm taking to the center right now. Like, you don't have to let the world know it to do it. And Beyonce and Jay-Z, they actually do give a lot secretly. You know
what
I'm saying?
Well, yeah, I know she put up some low-income housing in Houston and a lot of stuff.
I feel in my heart, ain't no way she just ain't done nothing. You know what I'm saying? But she's not like, let me announce what we're doing as a family.
I always have a problem when natural disasters happen and the citizens have to kick in. We've been kicking in the whole time. That's what I'm saying. Like, we kick in when we buy sodas. We kick in when they take the money out of our checks.
Yep.
Everything is taxed. Everything goes to these different places. They constantly, charities, whatever the case may be, FEMA, whatever it is.
Then?
Why the fuck are we donating? Like, where is the government? Step the fuck up.
Because government don't give a shit. We paying politicians.
They bailed the banks out. Go get that city and squishy it out and fix that shit. Why the fuck y'all not doing that? Y'all gonna bail the banks out? $400 million, that city, Houston, underwater don't cost $400 million. Like, you feel what I'm saying? They could do that, but they not gonna do that. Like, I just don't think, I don't even think all the money, like, look at all the people that donated to Katrina. I mean, Louisiana's still fucked up down there.
I know.
It's still shit fucked up.
So the money is being misappropriated, but the point is just like when you give to a crackhead on the street, you know they ain't finna go buy no clean clothes and get no soap. They finna go get some crack. But the point is you gave it from your heart. So the point is to give in hopes that it's going to the right people. Or that's why some people do choose to, like, you know what? I'm gonna send these clothes. I know some people need clothes. Or some people
I'd rather
need
do that. I would have went down there with my money.
Water, formula, something. But, you know, the point is, like, the way the world looks at you, like, do it now or else. Like, be married with children or else. Yeah. Be this. It's like, it's not right.
I'm not going to be pressured to do it because most of those places, they have staff they need to pay.
Yep.
They have them all over the world. That money is not directly going to them people.
It's not.
What do you guys think about the whole Joel Osteen thing? Some people are like defending him to the end, but
I don't know what happened. I'm not a Joel Osteen person. I can't listen to white people preach. I feel like
listen.
I don't care. I feel like
I don't like to listen to anybody preach, but actually I like Joel Osteen. I used to watch him because he was more like just a motivational speaker, you know what I'm saying, as opposed to he just always have a nice story or simile or metaphor to go along with this. But the point is, this what's been going on, like the stuff happening in Houston, he ain't opened the doors of that mega ass church to the people, and people was pissed off and started coming for him on social media, which he came back trying to defend himself, saying that they work closely with a spot up the street,
and that the place had some flooding.
You know, they said that church was about as dry as a desert. But they said
we don't let y'all up in here. This the mega church.
So now
they be messing up my seats.
Yeah, this fuss.
Oh wait, what's going on?
But they did that back in the, see, this is how you know white people don't ever change. They did that back in the day when in Europe, I swear to God, you know I be going with my history shit, but in Europe, when smallpox and all that shit broke out and they didn't know how to cure it, and they was going to the church, nigga, the priest was locking them out. They didn't want to get that
shit. Well, see, that's smart. Shit.
They was trying to get prayed over healers, because you know back then.
Girl, go pray to the sky, you make a change.
They locked them motherfuckers out.
Say, but seriously. He tried to come on and say that they worked closely with a place up the street that housed however many, and as soon as that was full and they said they needed their help, then they did open the doors, and Lakewood has always been here to help the people. And,
no, see,
you know, we've been working closely with them, and
race,
as soon as they
opened
up the doors of our church and allowed as many people as needed to come in, because God said, no, I'm just talking shit.
And
but no,
Donald Trump cut FEMA and all that emergency money for disasters and shit. They said he's trying to cut that if he didn't already to build the wall.
And him and his bitch didn't even head out there to like 4 or 5 days after the shit was going on. And she had on 6-inch heels. Everybody was like, bitch, where you going?
Right.
It's flooded, girl. Where is
she
your rain boots?
She trying to keep her ankles dry.
Look. My sister is, you know, they all in Texas, but they in a different part too. She said it's alligators and shit in the water. She was like, she called me like, bitch, it's alligators in the water. She said, you know, I ain't used to this shit. I said, bitch, you lying.
I quit, bitch.
She said, it's alligators in the water. I'm like, man, that's crazy.
Oh, crap.
Why do the levees keep breaking? Why are they not going out and doing
Well, I heard that Trump, in addition to that, I heard Trump didn't go see not one hurricane survivor. He didn't talk to
not one not family, one. Didn't hold one baby, right. Didn't go out there and carry one motherfucker across the CVS lot to act like you had a piece of a heart, you cold motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, you cold red motherfucker.
I feel like they're clearing the coast out, because why do the levees keep breaking? After Louisiana broke, if I was in charge of anything, I would be like, don't you want to check the other levees? So we don't have this kind of shit happening again. Maybe we need to rebuild the levees. Maybe we should put some money in that.
Nobody's thinking that. That's too much
Yeah, that's ridiculous. Like, what the fuck?
Sad.
Whatever.
It's really sad, though, you know. But the good thing is,
we're gonna build
the way black people come together, you know, like the way they out there dancing in the water like it stomped the yard. They out there like swimming with little umbrellas and shit. Like we really are like the
we
best
resilient.
People. Yeah, the best. Resilient, well, all of this.
We're spiritual. Like we God's people, but at the end of the day, fuck that. Tapping in that dirty ass water.
Yeah,
fuck
they
all
say
that.
There's disease, E. coli,
yeah.
And everything in the water.
And they're not gonna give y'all Medi-Cal after that.
We ain't meant to survive this shit. We drinking that something in this damn water. But you know, my point is, they making light of a real, real, real bad situation.
Yeah.
You know, like even my friends who live out there, my friend, she was like, if she would have been in her old apartment when she been moved less than a year, she like, they would have been underwater. Like, for real.
Yeah.
Her and her son.
And then if you can't swim, like, that's, and it rushes in, like, that's what I'm saying. I don't understand why they don't check the levees. Like, that's how you know the world is petty. Like, they check bitches that go to the county building more than they checking levees and shit. Like, to make sure. Bitch, turn your QR7 in every month. Bitch, you not gonna check the levees? But you checking these poor bitches?
Yeah,
to make
but
poor...
I can't have my $50 rent, yeah. Bitch. Fuck
it. Some fucking EBT. Check the levies, bitch.
Priority.
I can't take it. I can't. I'm done.
And then, y'all need to also know. Look, accept your blessing and go in your blessing. And just if you can't be happy for people, then just go the fuck on. Okay. Don't be doing no whole shit, dog. Like, y'all be out here on some bullshit, and you know God is good. He will let somebody see the shit you doing when they ain't even supposed to.
Yeah, shit be coming to the light, Po. It's crazy. I was out there, and other comedians were calling, talking about, why are we not on the show?
And yeah, you're going to get that.
Yeah, but I heard it, though. But so
she,
I know.
And she wasn't even supposed to be in there. Like, just
but
heard.
I already knew that, though.
And knew that. Heard
but it's I never do
but
that.
But you know what?
And was like, I've been doing it longer. And
you're going to get that. You're going to get that all through your career. So just be prepared to use it as a tool to motivate you or to keep your... Did you guys watch The Defiant Ones?
Not yet.
I've seen some.
Jimmy Iovine was talking about being a horse in a race. That's why they got the blinders on, so they're not distracted. Right. So you got to keep your blinders on and just keep rising. I mean, that's a great opportunity.
Great.
50 is a cool dude from what I understand. I met him a long time ago. He was cool. So...
I mean, I wasn't tripping. It was just appalling. The real thing is
just,
that it's fake
noted.
To you.
Just
because
noted.
Why would you want to? Why would you want to have to call? Why wouldn't you want to be more recognized? You feel what I'm saying? Like you making yourself. You don't feel bad.
Like because even us, like we push each other because we have to. Like we both should have submitted for that.
Yeah.
Look, we out here just doing shows. Whoop-de-whoop.
Well, who knows? Once Kamira gets in the door, then
no.
She,
I'm not saying it to say. I'm just saying like people know how good she is. That's why she got a call. Like, you need to come do this. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, that's how good you are. Not like we calling to get people numbers. Like, who do we call to be like, who y'all got?
And that's crazy that's because they, you got through too. So that means you knew people that was there and they still didn't call you.
Oh.
The people that you called to tell to call you.
Oh, wow. Yep.
It was right there.
Who got that connect where you can call right in?
You been knew them.
Oh my God, I can't take it.
Like it's just ridiculous. It's just ridiculous.
That's when you know you made it too. Is when you got people.
And I told her, and for God to just allow you to be right there at that moment to hear the name and to hear what was said, everything. It's like it's just a sign. It's confirmation.
I swear to God, like I never, every time somebody do something, I'm happy for them. If I want to do something that I see somebody doing in my mind, I say, I got to work harder.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Like, ooh, they're on that level. I want to be on that level. I have to work harder. Not I have to hate.
Right. It's inspiration. Like it make you feel like, wait a minute. Now, if it's right there, then I know I can get it too. Shit, let's go.
It's crazy.
But nah, motherfuckers looking at it like, hold up. How? Who approved? What?
And then if you can't do nothing else, be nice. Shit, bitch. And maybe somebody, I don't know. All I got to say is Godspeed.
Godspeed. Get your man cussing. All I got to say, fuck that bullshit. Godspeed.
Yeah, I ain't tripping.
So how was your week, Precious?
My week has been good. You know what? I have actually been chilling this week. I've been to the beach 3 days this week. Malibu, laid out, taking in the shit. I ain't got in the water yesterday. And
I should have gave you my metal detector.
Oh, my God.
And you probably, got one of those beach things.
Girl.
So. I'm going to find treasure one day. I know.
I hate it so much.
She really got one of those.
She wanted one for her birthday and got one.
Yes, I got a good one too. But I said I want.
Have you used it?
Hell no, I haven't
because I'm serious about it. So I'm gonna get me a book and I'm gonna make me a trail. And I want to go for real. We're gonna get snacks and shit because we're gonna be out there a minute.
Oh my God, I hate her. I'm glad I didn't have it because I would have been out there really. They would be like, what is this bitch doing?
You know what I was thinking, speaking of the beach, is you know they have like homeaway.com where you can rent a house on the beach. So I was thinking maybe within the next couple of months we could put our cheese together and do a weekend on the beach. It's really not that expensive.
I know.
We should.
And then you can have all night and all day to be...
And everybody laughed at me, but when I find my treasure,
oh my God.
When I find me a ruby, or
meanwhile,
something,
we're gonna be chilling.
Damn ring somebody done lost.
Something.
We're gonna be eating, playing cards, doing right. this, going out. She gonna still be out there.
Well, I know I am. I am. I'm serious about
like,
it.
Like, bitch, you better find something.
We gonna plan that, though.
No, we can. That'll be fun.
That'll be real good, yeah. actually.
I'm really serious about it. I wanna get an upgraded one, the one that costs $1,500.
Oh my God.
She ain't used the one she got now.
You trying to go deep, so the more expensive one goes deeper.
It goes
into
deeper,
the-
and it detects different stuff. Like the one I have detects like coins and stuff. Uh-huh. The other one detects like all the metals. You feel me? Like,
bitch, ain't nobody trying to collect all them damn metals.
Girl, we might find a coin from like a long time ago, slave coin or something.
Ain't nobody gonna find no damn slave coin.
I'm telling you,
what the hell? All right, y'all.
All right, so well, we're gonna change the name to the show, everybody. So
yeah.
We need some suggestions.
Yeah, we're gonna change the G spot, y'all. We're gonna change it. We're gonna get some fresh, new.
What about titties?
TNA.
TNA.
We all got titties. Shit.
So drop us some suggestions in the chat room, or you can go, you know, hit us up on our various social medias. I'm at OG Poetess and Morris Media, and then
Kamira White is
in One Precious Comedy. Yeah, so tell us, y'all, what y'all think the name of the show should be.
Right. So when we come back, we've got a couple news stories. So we're gonna take a quick break.
Grateful. Shout out to DJ Khaled.
Shout out to DJ Khaled.
Hey, I
know I love Angie Stone.
Did you see her on the radio show? She was talking about Usher and that whole thing.
No, but I just loved her because she
had a baby by D'Angelo.
Yeah, girl, because everybody was mad. I was like, "Do it, bitch, do it."
That's but did you see the Usher opening up for Kevin Hart's Heartbeat Weekend in Vegas? Yeah, it's on Friday. It's gonna be Usher's concert.
Oh, I wonder if
comedy
show. Oh, did it happen already?
No, it's this weekend, like the first, second. Third,
oh, Kevin Hart, cool, because I'm bougie. All that stuff going around, he couldn't be up in there with me.
Oh wow,
what I saw mean? That on the flyer. Yes, I did see that.
All in the trailers and drinking out of bottles and shit. We don't know. We partying. And where Usher shit at, y'all?
Pass the blunt to
yeah,
you and shit.
Pass the blood. Where is shit? Come here, Kiko, Miko. Get my bitch. Come here.
Oh, my God. Kiko, Miko.
Don't touch nothing, you got.
Yeah, I did see where Tori Hart and E. Nico ain't talking after that little Instagram little shit.
E. Nico was out of line.
You think so?
I read the...
You think so?
Yeah, I read the exchange. She actually brought Tori into it because a fan stated that, because she was like, I guess their anniversary.
It was their anniversary.
Year anniversary.
Somebody
yeah.
was adding up the years. Like.
Right. And so Eniko was like, yeah, a great 9 years when Tori and Kevin only been divorced for six years. So she was, so a fan did the math
just
and
like
was like,
do.
Yeah,
you thought
you need to watch what you say, because 9 years ago, that would have made you a mistress pretty much. And so instead of Eniko
ignoring
the fan, yeah. She responded by bringing Tori. Well, Tori been saying that, trying to put the mistress jacket on me. I'm just paraphrasing.
Yeah, because she didn't say that, but it was just kind of like they had been not together for. They've been separated too. Y'all know it takes forever for niggas to get divorced. Niggas be separated for forever. They've been separated 2 years. They didn't live together.
Well, then technically, like, you cannot get mad, but let's just call a spade a spade. Technically, bitch, if they took a long time to get divorced, you was a mistress, bitch. I know it don't sound good. I know he probably was at your house every night. I know whatever you feeling is what you feeling. But technically,
she wasn't a normal type of mistress. You know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
No, I know,
but she says in the response, Kevin had a lot of women while you were married. So she didn't have to say all of that shit. You know what I'm saying?
See, now Kiko, you don't want, look, Tori looks strong. She might not be funny, but the bitch looks strong. You better leave her alone.
Oh,
she gonna whoop your little
that.
Ass down. Kevin gonna have to get your little ass some security.
She waiting on you to drop that baby. Like, man. Yeah, just have that baby. Just have that
she
baby.
She already going to be jealous of their little family picture. You know, their little baby going to come out with curly hair and shit. She already going to be mad at you, bitch. Stay in your little Asian ass lane. She going to fuck you up.
Don't be crossing over this away. Shit.
Let that lady live. Lord, have mercy.
But you know what? She is, you know, in her defense, you know, I see both sides. She is pregnant. She is emotional. Don't, you know.
Yeah.
She ain't got nothing to do with them comments. And then she's like, well, matter of fact, whoop de whoop de whoop. And, you know, sometimes we just get slick at the tongue. And
you know.
They got to work together. They got the kids. You know, they're going to have to figure it out. Like,
and sometimes you do. You can't remember a lie. That's how you know. That's why I always tell the truth. I'll never remember my shit. I've been all like 10 years. 15,
for
you know?
Those who didn't hear the exchange, the girl, the Aniko said, I'm grateful to God every day for putting us together. And then back, she said, 8 years together, 1 year married, forever to go. So the fan replied and said, he hasn't even been divorced for 6 years yet. He got divorced November 11th. God, these fans.
Oh, my God.
Fans be all into me.
Are we sure that ain't totally
I'm here on? For y'all. I'm here for y'all, but you may not want to flaunt how long you guys have been together because that just fuels the rumors of you being a mistress. Just saying. And so Aniko responded and said, it's no problem at all. I'm basically immune to it now. Those rumors were spread from her years ago. she said because she wanted to play the victim and not own up to her wrongdoing as well. Singled me out as the mistress because we struck. Knowing damn well there were more women during their marriage, but I never wrecked any home. Now, to me,
that's a lie.
She was
to a fan, bitch?
Yeah.
Like, why is you telling your business to a fan? Kevin need to come home. She bored.
I'm sorry. That's funny.
No, she bored, my nigga. Like, I don't know. She shouldn't have did that. I would have just put hashtag I won.
Just apologize.
Yeah, it was not.
Tori want a reason. You always want a reason to beat the bitch ass. You always want.
For real, because even just listening to that, I'm like, oh.
Yeah, that would have pissed me off. You know, and Kevin kids is her kids, so you can't really, nothing. Like,
Tori came back with a
classy little statement or something.
That's because she gonna beat her ass.
Yeah, Tori don't play. Tori responded by saying, Aniko, sweetheart, normally I don't feed into this, but when you addressed me directly, you forced my hand to respond or to be made out a liar. We have made successful strides to become a loving co-parenting family, but you have now left it open for my character to be questioned. You, Kevin, and I know the truth. I offer this simple solution to your IG comment problems. Either respond truthfully or don't respond at all. Thank you for considering my advice, Tori.
Mm. Bitch, I'm going to tell you the last time to keep my name out your motherfucking mouth.
Really, I'm just saying the politically correct shit, because when I see you.
Kevin told me not to beat your ass or we're going to get my child support, but you're going to force my hand. You're gonna force my hand, bitch. And I'm being nice to this bitch, Kevin. You see? I gave her one, Kevin. You see? The next one, I'm gonna fuck her up, Kevin. I already know how I went. I gave her one. You see, I'm being nice to you, little bitch.
Shit, Tori from Philly.
Besides, she from where? Her, she Asian shit. She fucking around and know some shit, too.
She probably she gonna put something in that bitch tea. But Tori gonna whoop her ass.
Bitch, she might know some Karate Kid ass moves, bitch.
Oh, shit.
She trained.
She, look.
I don't know.
That's a deep kind of, let me tell you something.
Love.
No, bitch, that bitch took her meal ticket, bitch. I loved him. That's my baby daddy. And you took him right when he blew up. Bitch, we was probably living in Philly with roaches and shit. Bitch, I struggled with him. And then you here come your little ass and you took him. And he blown the fuck up, bitch. $86 million every year, bitch. If you say one more goddamn thing to me, I'm gonna beat your ass.
Yeah, I'm out here.
You better be glad I ain't beat your ass right now.
For real, I'm out here working out, trying to smile on every picture.
Yeah, I wouldn't have let that go. Hurt. Tori nigga, better than me.
Yeah.
That bitch would have got beat up every time he went somewhere with her.
Just because I'm childish. I could beat over him.
Exactly.
Nigga, I'm
just
because
she couldn't win. Bitch, childish. You're not finna win, my nigga. I've been struggling with, bitch.
That's why I don't want nobody. I'd
scare
fuck
her
that.
Away. She'd have been like, Kevin, I'm tired of getting hit.
Yo, whole shit on the line.
She can have you. I'm telling every. I mean,
nigga,
that's her.
You
nick,
put your whole
like,
life
everything.
On the line.
But Tori did turn it. Let's just call her. She did. That's what she was right. She did, bitch. You know.
Man, this shit's crazy.
She started telling knock knock jokes.
Oh, I hate you so much right now.
No, but that's what happened. Your nigga can't play football and you go off a wide receiver.
Oh my God.
This bitch didn't even want to be a cheerleader. She like, no, put me on the team. Put me on the team.
Put me in the game, coach. I'm ready. Put me in.
32.
But no, serious note, y'all, do keep the Houston victims in your prayers. That is major. Yeah. Harvey. And then, it's some bullshit, too. Prince sister. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Prince's sister that he never was with.
I got to meet her a few few months ago.
Oh, did really? Prince meet her? I never remember him talking about her.
Like, oh, my God.
They look alike. You don't think they resemble?
They might, but did she come to the house before he died?
Oh.
I'm just saying, while she know all his favorite colors
Prince,
and shit.
But no. Prince has always been secret, you know, private. So he didn't have his family out there like that. But I would imagine they might have been close. I don't know.
Well, they were so close.
The sister, is it Tika or Tyra?
Tika. I'm sorry.
Okay, so wrong. Tika Nelson, and she is the sister. Look, she done came up with some shocking news, y'all.
She's the shot caller right now.
Okay, so she's the, okay. She says that his favorite color was not purple. Well, all y'all going out getting all that purple shit and shit. She said it was not even purple. It was orange.
This is the petty shit. This is why you never came over. This is why he didn't write songs about you. This is why you was a ward of the court, bitch. He could have left your shit in writing.
See, you wanted too much. You wanted to shine. She mentioned...
That's what I'm saying.
She mentioned one of his beloved instruments, a piece she considers a standout piece, is his orange cloud guitar. The publication quoted Nelson is saying, it is strange because people always associate the color purple with Prince, but his favorite color was actually orange.
He always associate the color purple with him, bitch. What the fuck you mean? This nigga come out of, we ain't never seen this
purple
nigga in orange.
Rain.
Yeah. We ain't never seen this nigga in orange. Shit.
And wait a minute. He was known as the Purple One. And even after his death, there were numerous purple tributes from venues around the world and cities. Y'all know we lit up everywhere in purple. Downtown Dallas, fucking London, fucking everywhere. And they talking about Prince is so closely associated with the color purple that he now has his own shade.
Yeah, they just recently released a purple Prince color.
In the Pantene Color Institute.
And you are so petty that he has all that going on and you would just come out and be
talking
like,
about
it
some
ain't
orange.
Even his favorite color.
Now,
though.
What if everybody start changing to orange?
Nobody's not listening do that. To her.
Girl, we didn't know you before.
We didn't know the real Prince, bitch. We was really in his life, okay?
Girl,
you
need more people, bitch.
Yeah.
We don't believe you.
And if you was really his sister, you wouldn't be this petty. That's something you would tell people like, come here, Poe.
Yes.
No purple wasn't his favorite color.
Girl, all these people is dumb as fuck, girl. But
like,
you,
that's a, you know
you
what
only
I mean?
Tell your partner.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Well, she's actually planning some exhibit in London with some of his memorabilia.
Okay, and then we got Flav.
This is why parents, when you have two kids, hug both of them. You got to hug both. Not just the one that's popping. Hug both of them. Because,
you know, she actually wanted to be a singer.
Oh, see, that's what it is right there. And now the truth comes out. You better get your bodyguard. This is a Whitney.
They had a talent showcase at the house, and they was like, well, our money has to go to him because...
He can play an instrument.
He can do everything, bitch. You can't even
That's
split.
Why she know what instrument it was.
That bitch
orange
can't do the split.
Cloud guitar because you was watching him
no,
succeed.
No, she had to play with the orange one. Bitch, get the orange one up here. This is purple shit over here, bitch.
Everything purple is his. Don't touch it. That's fucked up.
That's crazy.
But anyway, girl, go to sleep and find something to do.
With that money,
yeah,
stop.
You got some money, girl.
She gonna spend all that money trying to do stuff for him so she could be in the limelight. She gonna go broke.
Just go vacation, girl. Go vacation. Get
you can't open up a monument everywhere.
She just doesn't whore his legacy.
She is. She ribbon cutting everywhere. Bitch gonna be at the alligator thing, ribbon cutting for Prince, all kind of shit. She tripping.
Alligator thing, ribbon cutting.
Yeah, alligator fair.
Okay, y'all. Look, moving on.
Oh, say it ain't so.
Say it. Oh, my God. I guess after the years of reality shit not working out and whoop-de-whoop. Flavor Flav, y'all. Flavor Flav done filed a damn lawsuit against fellow Public Enemy member Chuck D. and members of the rap group's production and management team.
Well, we need to get exclusive. Ain't that your homie? Yeah. He probably started actually, busting up laughing.
Both of them. In fact, I talked to Chuck not too long ago. He said he was going to come by at some point, but it's really sad. I mean, Flavor Flav is suing Public Enemy, claiming that they've been trying to etch him out of the business for years now, but yet they're still using his voice and his imaging on the merchandise. And he claims that they just put a new album out and he didn't know about it. He didn't approve.
We didn't know about it either.
He's mad that he didn't do Boy on the album that came out.
No,
he did do Boy. Nah,
because he never rapped. I don't remember him rapping. I just remember him. He rapped.
He did a little something.
He claims in this lawsuit that he penned over 50 of the Public Enemy songs, and that the new album is Nothing Is Quick in the Desert.
Mm.
And it came out end of June.
Okay.
I haven't heard heard
I didn't hear anything about that.
I don't think that anybody could etch him out of anything, because first of all, Flavor Flav, you should sue your parents. This is what, like, I think you're suing the wrong.
And did he just say, yeah, okay, even though he's penned for more than 50 Public Enemy songs, yeah. But then you come back and say he claims that no input on the creative direction on the...
He claims he went into the studio to record some stuff on that album, but he didn't get to approve. He didn't know that that was going to be like,
actually
the final,
what was gonna be
the
on
final
it.
Mix.
So he thought he was just in there freestyling, getting fucked up.
That's because just you're Flavor Flav. Like, that's what you do. You come
he
in.
He said
and
his voice and all that. He wasn't ready. And I'm like, how ready? You're not a singer, Flav.
That nigga think he Whitney Houston.
Wait, wait.
You
my,
don't
my
have
my
to
shit
get
was
ready.
Off. Wait.
La,
right.
La, 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 la. Boy.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, that's sad. Yeah. So
it sounded like he broke. You know?
Well, we haven't seen him on TV.
Well, he has a lot of kids.
Look, everybody start coming in with all the reasons why he is.
I don't know who the fuck was having his kids, but, you know.
Baby, well, look, Delicious and Hoops was all in kissing him in the mouth, so yeah. Ain't no telling who was having the kid. Anybody.
And that model, older, they used to be married to Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Oh, yeah, that white bitch. I'm sorry, my bad.
The white bitch.
The big one, the buff one.
When you remember they had a reality.
She was on Rocky,
Edge.
I think that bitch fought Rocky.
She ain't fought no goddamn
that bitch
Rocky.
Yeah, she was
the big Yugoslavian.
Yeah, the big
somebody
bitch.
In the chat room, what's old girl's name? But they had they were on a reality show.
Yes.
Oh,
yes,
I do remember that.
Yes.
She's the big Yugoslavian.
Right.
Yes, yes.
Oh yeah, with the blonde hair.
Yes.
Yes.
The crazy
yes.
One, the crazy
I do remember.
Yeah, yes.
You know
they
what?
They seem
know,
like they really loved each other.
They did. But you know what? That's so long ago. Look at
Bridget. Britt Nelson.
Oh, yeah.
Bridget that Nelson.
Bitch.
That's
she
her.
Was
yeah.
Crazy, too. Yeah. That's because, look, when you do cocaine,
it's a hell of a
you
drug.
You have sex. I mean, shit. They probably had some good ass sex. That big ass bitch and him. Please.
Looking at it, looked like it stank. It looked like they sex stank.
It probably did, but on cocaine. You know what I'm saying? Like, he probably looked good. He probably looked like a chocolate Denzel or something to her.
They seem like out of all the reality show relationships he's had, it seemed like that one was the real.
She liked him. She used to call him Poopy. And see, I don't like shit.
That's what he looked like, too.
But Poopy. That's why I can't date outside my race. I don't know if you playing, bitches. You for real. Like, Poopy, bitch.
Poopy, you being funny. Because he looked just like the poop
exactly.
On the motherfucking emoji,
exactly.
Nigga.
Poopy. Poopy. No.
Poop. Oh. Come here, little poop. Mm-mm. Poop, poop. Looking ass, too.
Mm-mm. I love okay. Flav.
Yeah, shout out to Flav, boo. But the truth is the truth.
You have an amazing, amazing character to be that ugly. You do.
Now, this story, I love it only because... Whoever you is, your dumb ass shouldn't even have this as a pet. That's what the fuck you get. But how about family parrot snitches on woman who killed her husband?
She's stupid because she should have killed the bird too. Because you
it sounds like a thousand ways to die, don't it? It sounds
yeah.
Like some crazy
oh,
shit.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, it do.
Like, okay, the police and family members believe the words repeated by Bud. First of all, the nigga named Bud. The parrot's name is Bud.
But and he's 19.
How
does
he get to be
19?
How old do parents live to be?
I know somebody with a bird that talks shit. Like, I know.
So you know it's real.
Yes, they Tierra mom and dad have a bird and he love the bird and she be like, I'm gonna kill that bird. He be like, you better not kill my bird. Yeah, he talk. Yeah.
Say, this bud, 19 years old, so it's a grown man. And it's a African oh, you know it was African gray parrot.
They just trying to say we snitching.
Yeah, they just made that shit up. Ain't nobody never heard no goddamn African gray parrot. Y'all gonna try to make it black. Motherfuckers. You know what? This is... Okay. But they saying the Bud, a 19-year-old African gray parrot, may have been the last word spoken by Martin Durham, a man who was shot 5 times by his wife, Glenna Durham. Now she been sentenced to life in prison. But she was found guilty of shooting him 5 times in May after the couple's pet parrot spoke words that may have helped seal the deal. The bird was heard saying, "Don't fucking shoot. Don't fucking shoot. Don't fuck." And the authorities believe these were the last words the husband said before the fatal shots were fired by his wife.
But how you know it, I fired him? He said, "Don't." He didn't say, "Don't fucking shoot, bitch."
Yeah. Yeah, how you gonna blame me? They didn't say my name.
And how could you really use that for evidence?
Because you know how close white people are to animals and shit. They will sentence you to longer for fucking leaving a dog in the car or some shit than a real live murder.
That's true.
So if that parrot said, don't fucking shoot.
They believe it.
They believe that shit. If they say that parrot said that shit, he said it.
They probably brought him to court too. Like, you know, parrots don't fucking shoot.
They put him up on the stand and shit. Like, so tell us exactly what happened. What did he say? Don't fucking shoot.
Yeah, that's what they do.
Say.
Oh my God. Because that other one be cussing too. I'm telling you, they really like that. They really like that.
But it do say it helped seal the deal. So it wasn't like the final call, like, yep, that's the DNA. But it definitely did not go against the evidence that they already had.
They are. White people always killing their husbands. You know,
they don't give a... They are gangster
as fuck. We might beat our husband's ass. We don't ever kill him, though.
Speaking of that, did y'all see the little footage they have of that police officer stopping that woman and telling her to use her phone or do something? And she was like, well, you know, all the stuff that's been going on.
Yes, you have to pull that up. We don't kill white people, girl.
He was like, no, we only shoot black people.
Yeah, relax.
The police officer said that. You can hear it.
Yes, yes.
On the audio, you can hear it.
She was like, well, I just don't want to reach for anything because of all the stuff going on in the news. And he was like, oh, you white, bitch.
We don't do that to black people.
Yeah, we don't shoot black people.
Did you guys see the woman who cussed out the reporter on CNN?
Oh, the black woman.
Yeah.
Yeah, because or were they both doing an interview and that dude tried to call her something? He tried to say something.
Nah. This sister was with her kids. I'm going to play that clip while we look for the other one.
Because, baby, I saw that and I'm like, it's just gay. You taking it too far. Weekend.
I missed everything. Joel Osteen and...
Okay. Oops. Oh, damn. What do I got on?
Camera on. You got the camera on.
Okay, yeah. She.
Your voice. And you going to really say that to somebody? Like, with the shit
all this as well. What can you tell us?
Microphones trying to ask us what the fuck is wrong with us.
So I'm sorry.
You really trying to understand it with the microphone still in my face, with me shivering cold, with my kids wet, and you still putting the microphone in my face.
Sorry.
Rosa Flores, it sounds like you got a very upset family there.
Yeah, well, I can make y'all way out here for some interviews with cameras this dry and all of this. Meanwhile, say, dog, like, that shit is bullshit. They just want to report some shit.
All the time. That's crazy.
You can't fault that woman at all.
And they don't even have nothing set up to where they giving motherfuckers blankets and snacks for telling their story. That's some bullshit. If you're going to do something.
Like, I'm cold, I'm with my kids.
Yeah, they hungry and shit, and you interviewing them, like, come on, like, damn. That's crazy. You know the news is, look.
Yeah, I found the world other one. Let me load it up real quick.
The world is fucked up.
So messed up, and they don't curl. And like you said, it's enough money somewhere. Where it shouldn't be. And we should have a damn Costco house full of shit for times like this. Not just in our house with no flashlight and no dumb shit.
The grocery store throwaway food after the expiration date in the trash.
Yeah, speaking of that, we do need to be more prepared. Like, even here in California, we don't have hurricanes, but we do have earthquakes.
Yeah.
And we don't want to get caught out there with no water, no. Because I was thinking, like, when they had if they had a nuclear attack. I said this studio would be great because the walls in this part they're lead. They're like steel for the soundproofing.
Right.
So you're supposed to be inside. I said this would be an ideal place to come.
Oh, well, good. I'm glad.
Some shit came down.
Yeah.
Only us.
right. That's not for everybody.
No, because you gotta, you know, we don't have enough money to do no real bomb shelter. If it's a nuclear war, we're gonna get fucked up.
Yeah.
For real. Like,
no,
so.
They had something on television or on internet on what you should do in the event that there's some kind of attack like that.
And
but
that's
anyway.
The thing too that killed me too, that I'm putting in my damn comedy too. So, like, what do okay, so earthquake. What we supposed to do?
My poor baby. She like, what we supposed to do?
And then just like us, doing all them damn tornado drills and shit, getting down, covering our head. That ain't gonna save my life. You had me on some bullshit.
You supposed to get in the doorway because the beams, like, this is all like stucco. It'll fall through. The beams are not gonna, you know. Oh, that's like, it's real shit.
I was here for the, I think it was 97 earthquake, the Northridge earthquake, where the 10 broke, the 10 fell, like part of the freeway collapsed.
I was here for all earthquakes.
I caught them all.
People that aren't from here are so scared of earthquakes, even the small ones.
I went to Hampton, Virginia, and let me tell you, I've experienced an earthquake and a tornado. Fuck tornadoes, okay? Like, they took the whole roof off the motherfucking school. I was like, Mom, I'm not safe here. This shit is, it's a hole in the roof.
And
like,
that's what killed me. They was trying to prepare us for tornadoes. I'm from where we supposed to have tornadoes, and we have had them, never in my area, but they always have our ass lined up in the hallway getting down, covering our head. Why is we not like them tornado chasers trying to get the fuck away from this thing? Like, if it's coming this way, why we ain't going the other way? Why is we getting down covering our head? We gonna really die in this motherfucker.
I could, yeah.
That shit
crazy.
Not gonna save you. Shit, I just make up some.
I can't do no tornado shit. I wake up in my house across the street. Yeah, like, shaking is cool.
I was scared out here at first with the earthquakes. But because I've been in a couple smiles. Then sometimes they'll last a little long. It's like, wait a minute. But
one time I was interviewing, actually, Flava Flav and Chuck D a long time in like late 80s or early 90s. And there was an earthquake right when we were doing the interview. And it scared the shit out of Flav.
Oh my God.
He said that was his first. Earthquakes don't really scare me, though. I think they're exciting.
They don't scare me, but I know because I'm like in the science that there is going to be one that fucks us up. Because, you know, if it just keeps shifting, it's going to be a break, supposedly. I mean, it's going to be one bad.
I know my daddy, I always say, boy, you out there in Cali, you just going to fall off in the ocean, boy. I'm telling you.
I believe in my faith so strong that every time there are natural disasters, like, okay, I know the people in Houston, there's some black people affected, just like Katrina. But most of the time, God really just fucked the white people up. Like, I mean, like, fires and shit. Like, we don't live up there. Don't shit happen in Inglewood, nigga. Don't nothing like, but where we at, nigga?
Speaking of
Maybe up on Hollywood Hills, they whole house fall down, bitch, the whole hill.
Speaking of Kamira's excellent expertise ratios of who gets fucked up,
I'm just saying.
We gonna move on to our advice.
Wait, before we do the advice letter, I pulled up the video.
That one video, y'all. Yeah, yeah. Look, check this out, y'all, because this is some bullshit.
This is why we need reparations.
Open the door.
No, you know, wrong and strong, like, just so proud of it. But you're not black. We only kill black people. You're just so proud of that.
Look, I'm not surprised. I tell you all the time, I don't even know why the fuck we still here. The president was like, when the white supremacists, because you got to look at how, that's why I don't like English, because they use those words fucked up. But he was like, white supremacy shouldn't be displayed in the public view.
In the public view, but it should be displayed.
Yeah, privately, you can hate niggas all day. But don't do it outside. Like, it's like, please, if like, it's an injunction on, like, gangs. Like, it's so cold where it's certain gangs where if it's, like, three of them in a car, they could just automatically go to jail just because they're together, because it's a junction on that gang. But these KKK, these white supremacists, don't nothing happen to them. Nobody's following them.
They don't even barely show up.
They dismantled the Black Panthers in one day, and every little setup, when every state that they had it in, like Chicago, wherever the Black Panthers was, in one day the FBI wiped them out. Yeah. And they wasn't even doing shit.
But trying to help.
I wonder, we're going to have to do a follow-up on that and see if that cop ended up getting fired.
Cause yes, because now he's on a leave, probably paid.
Man, he ain't
but he's on a leave
fired.
Right now while they investigate.
Oh, really?
That's what's going on right now while they investigate.
The president just said that it's okay for white supremacists to go up. Like, he just said, like, I mean.
He gave him the okay.
Why are we still here is what I want to know. I want to know why we still here trying to think it's going to change. Like, why? Any other race could come over here and get it. They still fucking with us.
Meanwhile, they singing church songs in the damn gym.
And we ain't even do none of them. Excuse me, y'all should be hugging us. Like, I feel like white people, when they see us, they should be like, oh, hey, guys. How you guys doing?
Yeah, I hope you're fine.
Like, oh, my God, I'm happy.
Are you hungry?
You know what I'm saying?
You need something?
When they see black people in Benz's, they should clap. Yeah. Like, at the end of the day, like, it shouldn't be like that. Why y'all hate us? We should hate y'all.
And that's for real.
I heard this week, too, that they're going to change Columbus Day here in L.A. to Indigenous Peoples Day. And the Italians were upset about that.
For what?
Because Christopher Columbus was an Italian explorer that they rewrote history about.
Oh, I know. He's a white. Oh, my bad. No, he was a white Italian. Okay, well, guess what? We don't care if you mad, okay? We taking down the damn Confederate-ass statues and shit and putting up Martin Luther King's. We
Oh, Barack Obama's.
Barack Obama's and Muhammad Ali's on y'all ass. So,
all right, well, we got the advice letter. What we got?
Okay, y'all. Our favorite part. Because what we do as comedians is try to spread our good expertise advice into the world. Yes. So today our letter says, Dear Precious and Kamira, I've been going out with this guy I met online about 3 months. Mm. When we finally met in person after exchanging messages and talking on the phone, we clicked right away. Oh, girl, that's good. We've been nearly inseparable for the past 2 months. I really like this guy a lot, but I have a dilemma. Last Saturday, a friend of mine had a get-together at his house for the Mayweather fight. I noticed that my guy and one of my female friends named Lucia were acting a little strange around each other. Mm. I didn't say anything at the time because I thought I might have had too many drinks and didn't want to trip. Mm-hmm. Anyway, a few days ago, me and Lucia went shopping, and I felt a funny vibe from her. So I asked what was up and why she was acting like that at the party. Well, she told me that she used to date my new boyfriend about 4 years ago, and that she got pregnant by him, and he forced her to get an abortion by begging and pleading with her, and sometimes in a threatening manner. They broke up shortly after she got the abortion. She said he was real cool up until she got pregnant. I mean, what kind of guy forces you to get an abortion? And should I talk to him about this, or should I abort him? Signed, No Baby Ghost.
Every guy I know forces bitches, try to force his bitches to get abortions. I don't know why.
Hey, what you talking about? What type of guy? A normal guy?
Yeah, a normal one. A regular one. A preacher.
Or anyone you find anywhere. Yeah. Shit. Yeah. A married one, with a girlfriend, a single one, mm-hmm. a poor one, a rich yeah. one. Like, But shit. The thing about it is, that's just all on you, girl. And really, you know you like that dude. Y'all got real close. Y'all been inseparable for 2 months. You only been dating him 3 months. You met him online. You knew the door was open for anybody to be done met this guy before, girl. 4 years ago, your homegirl was pregnant by him. Now, you cool with that or what?
Nah. Nah, I'd have to let him go.
Yeah, are you cool with that or no? And if this your friend, why didn't you know that?
Yeah.
Well, she might have not known this girl 4 years ago.
Oh, yeah, that is true. However it go, girl.
Then hell no, because she'll fuck him again.
Right.
If y'all not real. Y'all just met type shit? No.
Well, if they weren't having gotten together in the 4 years and then they broke up because this guy, you know.
But if you feel the vibe.
And then she met her 2 years ago and she calling her a friend, and then you think she going to be cool with you? Like, you think she not going to mess with him on the strength of you? Mm-hmm. And y'all 2 year relationship?
And even
she had an abortion by this nigga?
An abortion that she didn't want. He made her.
Yeah.
And that's the other thing, girl. Why would you say it? Girl, just go have it.
Bitches always want to get pregnant the second time so they can be like, I'm not doing it again. I'm not.
Bitches love to lock a dude down. They like, that's cool, baby.
No, I had a friend who got pregnant by a celebrity, a major celebrity.
Okay.
And he literally had his people take her to the clinic and get the abortion.
Well, you know what? That's some old gangster-ass shit.
Few years later, because I would have hid out for 9 months. You wouldn't even found me if you was threatening to make me have an abortion. But
you better ask me nicely.
She got.
That's all I gotta say.
You ain't even gotta come take me. Look, you better just hurry up and contribute because I'm going.
What,
on my
nigga?
Own.
I do it on the stream just because you telling me I better do something. Like what? I wouldn't even want the fucking baby and be like, Precious, this motherfucker told me I better kill the baby. I love this baby. You don't fucking tell me no shit like that.
I got a friend who did that too.
Shit, like, name the baby right after him.
Then now she had a baby by someone else that ended up just not even helping.
I don't. You not finna punk me like that. You not about to come have your people. Did you send your people over here to fuck me? You not about to have your people come over here and strong arm me into no abortion. Because you know they say, you know what they do at the abortion clinic? They ask you, do you want this abortion or is somebody forcing you? I'd have been like, someone's forcing me and they're out there in the lobby right now. Help, bitch. What the fuck?
I'll be like, they think they forcing me. I don't want this shit my damn self. Please hurry up and take it.
Are stupid, Precious. You are stupid.
Give a fuck. And look it out.
No, but that's not cool. That's not cool. It's really especially not. Because you did it to me.
Like, oh, come on. We did it to each other.
No, we did
it.
No, but I'm just saying, like, no, because no, the way I'm, no, because it's some niggas that know how to fuck you and don't do that.
Nah, we did that shit to each other, dog. Like, you can't just be like, you can't be holding a dude inside you while he coming and shit and be like, that's fucked up, you did that to me.
I'll be like, you about to come as soon as a nigga's face starts scrunching up. What is you doing? Wait a minute. Hey. Snap out of it, motherfucker. Get up.
I don't. I'm terrible. I'm going to keep it a gun. Where you coming in?
Oh, you want to make them hard.
Childish.
That's because you don't got no kids, bitch. I'll be running from them. Fuck that, bitch. Just shoot that shit over there. I'm going to change the sheets. I don't want to roll over in it. Fuck that.
Stupid.
Shit.
All right, y'all.
Don't forget to keep the suggestions coming.
For the name of our show, y'all. Right.
Yeah, and don't fuck with this boy. Baby goes. No baby goes.
Girl, look.
Give out your info.
My social media is Kamira White on Facebook. Kamira White is on Instagram. And Kamira White on Snap? Everything, Kamira White.
When's your 50 Central coming out?
September 28th, I think it airs. I don't know if it's going to be my episode, but it starts September
28th. Can you talk
28th.
About what your skit was?
Set.
She's doing
it's
stand-up.
It's my stand-up.
Stand-up comedy.
Oh, it's stand-up. It's stand-up.
I thought you did a skit. Oh, mm-hmm. Okay.
It's stand-up. It's stand-up.
And you felt good about it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And they had like a live audience?
Uh-huh. I had a live audience, and it was real cool. It was real cool.
Okay.
I didn't get to ask them 21 questions, though, but damn. It was I know.
Well, you never know. He might ask you back to do some things.
Hey, I could have sworn I swear he looked me up and down. Like, I seen him start at my toes and go up, and I was like, I think he looking me up and down. But, you know, my insecureness was like, bitch,
no,
he ain't looking your fat ass up and down.
Out, bitch, you
but
fine.
Hell
bitch,
yeah,
you
Kamira,
out.
You have so good. Many fans. Believe that.
Don't tell me that, because I would have been like, nigga.
He was on you. He just 50, so he couldn't just jump right then, but he chilling. Like, next time y'all work together, next couple of
you
times.
You got titties and
he gonna
ass.
Be on you. He's going to be. Shout out to Screw Roy Rice, y'all. Yeah. That's our homie. He's shooting his special tonight. And he looks out. Yeah, he been looking out since I've been in the game. And so
he been doing specials for a long time. So I know he gonna hit
that. I didn't know he was from Inglewood, right?
Oh, my God. Is he from... is it Long Beach or?
I just know he a blood. I'm sorry. I just ask niggas where they from. I know he's a blood, and I know his wife is a Crip. This is what I know.
I can't take it, y'all. Look, you know
hysterical.
What? Shout out to him. Have a great special.
Yeah, we won't be here on Monday. The studio's closed on Monday, but
where the
girl...
fuck you going? You don't just
I'm
you
going
tell
home.
Us that.
I'm going to see my mom.
Yes. Poe has
it's the holiday. It's Labor Day.
Is bitch, that ain't no holiday. We black. Labor, it's Labor Day. We got a Labor
Just barbecue Labor again. Yeah.
But we'll be back again on Thursday if that works for everybody. So.
Okay.
Okay, cool. All right, y'all, one Precious comedy.
OG Poetess and at Morris Media Studios. Please follow our social medias. We have a new sponsor coming, so we got to get our numbers up.
Sponsored up around this.
So follow Precious, follow Kamira, follow Morris Media Studios, and follow
And if
OG
you
want to
sponsor us, like, we accepting weed hair,
baby.
Bras, like,
If you want to sponsor, email us at contact@morrismediastudios.com and we'll help you blow your brand up. So,
boom. That's what that is, y'all. Have a great weekend. Thanks for tuning in. Yes. And we're going to holler at y'all.
Thanks for all the support, guys. I love you.
Yeah, we love y'all. Deuces!